What is about to follow is essentially my first gameplay video in a while where I'll be playing Raid Racer. Just a bit of a behind the scenes. There was some issues with the capture card and some of the video. In places it looks like it's kind of corrupted. Not sure why that is, but yeah, kind of what discourages me from doing gameplay videos, to be honest, is just when I have problems. I mean, I've had the PS3 out, the PS2 out, oh, different leads, all sorts, and yeah. But anyway, enjoy the video. Actually, you probably won't. But yeah, originally this was going to be a two-part video because of the kind of restrictions on video length on the camera, on the memory card. But since I had the problems and all that stuff, it's just now one video. So when it says, it's ready for part two, whatever I said, just ignore it and carry on watching. And here it goes. Hello and welcome to what is kind of my first, let's say, gameplay video in a while. I've just been having a break doing the old channel updates, pickups and all of that stuff, and kind of doing this video, I realized why I was having a break, because fucking it was absolute misery setting this thing up to record, all sorts of silly issues, and then it turns out the original way that I tried to record worked, but it didn't work the first time, so I fucked about for ages. But anyway, we are playing Rage Racer, which is a game I know a bit about, which is kind of a bit of a change from my usual videos because a lot of the time I'm just playing shit games that I've never played before. So this is the third iteration of the console versions of Ridge Racer, the arcade game. The first Ridge Racer's kind of a port of the original arcade machine, I believe. To be honest, I've never actually played them in the arcade, only on the PlayStation and other consoles. Ridge Racer Revolution, I'm not sure whether that was a port of, I believe it was Ridge Racer 2 in the arcade. But this game here, Rage Racer, this is a kind of console exclusive game. The third Ridge Racer game in the arcades was Rave Racer. So yes, this is a pretty cool game. It was released, I believe. Why isn't the controller working? That wasn't how. Oh, there we go. I believe this came out shortly before Gran Turismo. So many people probably played Gran. Well, they did actually. Many people played Gran Turismo, obviously, but not many will possibly have played Ridge Racer by comparison. So we're going to go ahead with Grand Prix here. Now, I must say, unfortunately, due to all the fucking about and stuff, I actually have no audio whilst I'm kind of playing the game. There is audio, but it is going into the computer, and for some reason, it's not coming out into my TV setup. Actually, I'm just going to try something on the fly here. See if I get any sound. Yes, I have a little bit of sound. So, right. Skip the bollocks. Let's get in here. So, I'm going to first show you how kind of a lot of people play Ridge Racer games. So we're just going to race start. And this is basically how you don't play a Ridge Racer game. And it really annoys me because the majority of videos in and around YouTube consist of this style of playing. So the first thing people do is they play in the kind of, what do you call it, a third person perspective, the behind the car view. Everybody who knows anything about Ridge Racer knows that the behind the car view is always shocking in Ridge Racer games. So here we're playing Brake.
yeah, break round the corners. We're playing it grip style, was what I was trying to say there. And that is just not how you play Ridge Racer. So you come in, you put the brakes on, you go around the corner, try not to hit the barriers. And it's just awful when you play it like that. How you should play Ridge Racer is drifting. And I probably can't do it on this car because this game actually has kind of adjustable grip and grip levels. You can set it up for grip or drift in the menu. And this is kind of set up at the default, which makes it very hard to drift around corners. This car here is a Nade, I call it a Nade, it's a G-N-A-D-E, Esperanza, I believe. And yeah, this game has a really gritty look compared to the other Ridge Racer games. To be honest, the graphics have aged terribly in this game. There's a lot of kind of tearing of the polygons, I guess you'd call it, especially when you go around these kind of hilly areas. Can we get a drift on around this corner? No. So yeah, as standard with the car set up as default, it's impossible to fucking drift around corners, which is stupid. One interesting aspect of this game, obviously we're used to car customization now with the likes of Gran Turismo, Forza. Well, as I said earlier, I believe this game came out a little bit before Gran Turismo, maybe 6 months or so. I'm not, you know, I'm going off the top of my head there. But this had car customization in, not massive levels, but you could upgrade your car to the next class and then it, you get body kit. The Fiat 500 type car in here, it had the engine gradually hanging out the back as you upgraded it and stuff like that. You get wider arches, bigger spoilers, and you can also customize the decals on your car, so a bit of customization to the game, so that is nice. And it was kind of, I mean, it shouldn't work really slamming that into a Ridge Racer game, but it did. And I was kind of disappointed with when Ridge Racer 4 came out, they went for just numbers of cars, and it was like, oh, it's got 750 cars, and they're all, you know, variations of the cars. Like a car would have like 4 or 5 different variations, and you couldn't modify the car as far as I remember, but you know, that was just shit. One thing I would like to say has aged very well is the music. I didn't actually like music in this game when I played it. I was probably about 14, 15 when I had this. Yeah, I couldn't really stand the music. But now I think it's actually very good. I did like the crazy kind of Japanese techno tunes of the first game and Ridge Racer Revolution. I think Ridge Racer Revolution has got the better tracks, to be honest, but yeah, these have grown on me over time as my kind of music tastes have changed growing up. It's kind of got a very drum and bass, early 90s kind of rave scene vibe going on with the soundtrack. And there we go, we have finished. That was absolutely boring misery because I couldn't get sideways. Yeah, and it has replays, something that games kind of tend to omit sometimes these days, and you don't really notice, to be honest, because I never watch the replays anyway. So yes, we win prize money, and like I say, you can spend that on tuning your car up. But it's not like buying separate items, it's a whole package, so there's no tinkering in that sense. And I'll change the track there, go car select, I'm going to customise. So we want to customise the tyres. I'm going to go right over there to drift. Transmissions, just, you know, manual or automatic. So we start the race, and we are on Overpass City, which was probably my favourite track in the game. There's only three tracks in the game, and what happens is you complete the game, and then, is it Extra GP it's called? It puts another menu item on the main menu. I believe it's called Extra GP, and basically that's the same tracks, but mirrored. Are they mirrored, or are they racing? They might be racing the other way around. There is a difference between mirrored and racing the other way around. So that's how you play Ridge Racer right there, getting sideways and shit. Kind of a low quality tyre screeching sample though nowadays on there. So this is my kind of favourite bit of this course here. Sideways out there. And yeah, this bit here where you just got these like ridiculous hills that just kill you, fucking Nade Esperanza. And obviously the more you kind of tune your car and get better cars, the faster you'll go up that steep incline there. A lot of the cars that you race against, you can't actually buy them cars. Just for information there. Ooh, that's a bad drift. The car doesn't really drift that well in standard form. You want the lizards in this game. Unfortunately, one thing this game did do was try and kind of force you onto manual transmissions. There's a few cars in the game that are only manual transmission, which kind of sucks. The lizard cars, there's a... fuck off, ringing me. Sorry about that. Turn my phone off. Ah, man, that's just ruined my video. Yeah, sorry about that, and we're back. What was I saying? Yeah, the lizards, there's a nice, really nice looking pickup truck in the game, which has really good acceleration and drifting, but it is manual transmission, so yeah. To be honest, if this was a more realistic game, I might fancy tackling the manual transmission. But going sideways ridiculously like you're doing this game, trying to change gear, what the fuck's that all about? That just don't make any sense to me. Engine sounds aren't great in this game, but I think a lot of it's to do with kind of memory constraints. Obviously you got the full kind of soundtrack on there. And what you kind of didn't realise at the time with these early CD games, you're not actually most of the time getting CD quality audio, because if you think about it, you've got a CD's worth of music on the disc, and then a shitload of sound effects, and then the actual game itself on the disc. So yeah, some of it kind of had to be downsampled if it's not of the highest quality, as you can kind of hear with the female announcer. Luckily the announcers in Ridge Racer games never managed to be too irritating. I think it's Burnout 3, or is it Burnout Takedown, springs to mind of irritating commentators. You do have to be a fan of the Ridge Racer games to just pick them up and enjoy them. Otherwise, you'll just pick it up and you'll think, what the fuck is this shit? Because, to be honest, Ridge Racer games, the collision detection tends to be kind of very off. Like if you knock into other cars, it's just weird. So yeah, if you're expecting a realistic game or something that's easy to get into, this isn't for you. But if you're a serious racing game fan, I think you'll enjoy Ridge Racer when you put some hours into it. Obviously, I'm talking as, you know, looking at the series here, because obviously I'm playing Rage Racer. I'm aware of what is coming out of my mouth. Mostly up to shit. Yeah, teach this sucker a lesson to the big fucking dirty drift. And then overtake him up the hill. Yeah. Alright. I would usually do a lot better than this. I mean, I played this game the other day, and I actually saved it. I was going to load it, but I couldn't be bothered. And I came first in kind of every race to begin with. So I just find it very easy, like, especially the Ridge Racer and Ridge Racer Revolution. Because they're kind of a bit more... They're a bit easier to drift, to be honest, than this game to begin with. So I'll say this car's set up to grip. And you're kind of stuck with it to begin with. Once you do kind of progress through the game, you get ridiculously fast cars. I mean, this game isn't slow by modern standards, just playing with this shitty slow car. But it goes fucking mental. More mental than, say, something like Wipeout. And it gets to the point where you can, like, do that I just did, where I kind of tried to spin it round, except I failed there. But when you kind of tuned your car or got a better car, you can spin all the way around and do it while you're going around corners. It's like you're doing donuts while going around corners. So yeah, that's pretty fucking ridiculous. The game just goes mental, and I don't even know whether you can actually complete this game, because there's some, like, ridiculously futuristic cars later on in the game, and when you do the extra GP, you get right to the end, and then they do like 700 miles an hour or something silly, I seem to remember, and it is fucking impossible. If you remember the kind of devil, in the car shop, give you a sample of the cars. So yeah, that's your grip car, your age, your lizards, your ones to get sideways. That one there is, you can have that automatic transmission. That's cool. Yeah, so obviously as you go through the game, you can unlock more cars and shit. I just need to check the bloody camera, see what we're like for time. Oh, we're fucking flying. So stay tuned for part two, because we're gonna run out of time here. So here we go with a bad start. Part two of me playing some Rage Racer. I'm surprised that I managed to actually play. Well, I'm surprised I managed to chat so much shit. Well, like I say, usually when I do a gameplay video, I don't know shit about the game, but I did play this a lot when I was younger. Now, as you can see, it's like the first two Ridge Racer games on the PlayStation, where you've kind of got a main track and then all of the courses branch off from there. Oops. This was kind of probably my least favourite track, just because in my opinion this track kind of favours the grip cars more. You see a lot of tearing as well in the graphics, which isn't good. So you've got bits like this that are just a bit difficult to navigate if you drift in. I mean, you might think that's not a problem from the way I just took that, but try doing it at like 300 mile an hour. Something fucking stupid. This game gets silly fast. Oops. So, no, a bit where you can lose time, especially when there's some twat in the way. Get out of the way! Shit car! Fuck's sake! Like I say, collision detection is not great in the earlier Ridge Racer games. I think it's very unfortunate that Ridge Racer Unbounded was the last kind of Ridge Racer game. Also, they have kind of proclaimed, due to kind of people being less interested in it over time, because that Ridge Racer Unbounded, I played a little bit of a demo of it once and then refused to play it ever again because it was just fucking diabolical. Oh, unnecessary drift there, trying to showboat in a shit car. Oops. Can be a bit of a pain in the arse to kind of gather momentum in this game when you come to a standstill. Because you do have to be kind of going to had a bit of a lick to actually get a drift on. Oops. Of course, when you play with the in-car view, which you should be doing in a Ridge Racer game, you get the mirror so you can see what's behind you. If I hit the external camera, you don't get a mirror and it makes the game harder. And it makes the game harder anyway because the external view is shit. Who bloody programmed it? And why are they so shit at doing it? Also, when you're playing the external view, it doesn't actually kind of feel like the car is on the track, it feels like it's floating. Like the front end of that car just went through my car. There we go. Impossible drifting, you can't see where you're going, so stick to the internal camera. Oops. Do you think it's a shame that they didn't go with the bright, vibrant graphics of the first two games? I mean, I could understand if they were going a bit more realistic, which I guess they kind of are with the upgrades and all that shit, but yeah, the game does kind of feel a little bit depressing at times, just the whole grayness of it. It's a shame, really, that I don't have my PS1 hooked up at the minute for recording. Reason being, I'd have slapped in the Explorer FX and, you know, got a code and unlocked some of the faster cars in the game, because there's no actual cheats for this game like most Namco games, so you do have to play through the game and unlock shit. Although, I guess it is possible, thinking about it, that I could get download a save, because I am playing here on my PS3. So I guess I could probably download a save from the internet if I could find one and then put it on my PS3. Correct me if I'm wrong in the comments. Could do that, but I didn't, so. And to be honest, if you jump in at the deep end, the fucking, you'll have no chance. Cars get mental. I'm a full operator. Oh, didn't get my drift on. That, I'm gonna finish this. And then that's the end of the video. Oop. ball. So there we go, Rage Racer. What I wanted to kind of achieve with this video, which I've kind of failed because my drifting was shit, but that's partly to do with the fact that it's an early car in the game and it's not designed for drifting. You want the lizards for the drifting, you want the age for grip, and this is in the middle, kind of mediocre. So yeah, I couldn't really get my drift on, but if I was playing the original Ridge Racer, I'd be going sideways around every corner pretty much perfectly. So yeah, I just wanted to do a video because it annoys me when I see people play Ridge Racer games and they're not drifting. That is the idea of the game, and they're like, oh, I like this game, it's really good, and you're thinking, shut the fuck up, you're not playing the game right. It's not enjoyable unless you're drifting. You can't win the later races in the game without drifting, it's impossible. And people are like, oh, I like it, it's very arcadey, it feels old. They could kind of, if you know, if you're a Ridge Racer kind of player and you've played the games and you know what you're doing, they could kind of re-release a HD version of this, fix the sound, fix the fucking shit graphics, and it'd still play amazing. It's just you've got to know what you're doing. It's not hard. It's just like a tap, a let go and a tap of the accelerator as you go around a corner, you get sideways and you adjust it. It's nice. So yes, there we go. There we go, there we are. Rage Racer for the PS1, one of the absolute classics for the system. One of my kind of fondest memories on the system. Thanks for watching and goodbye. Hopefully, just one last thing, hopefully I will do some more videos, some more gameplays, might get back into it. Yeah, thanks for watching and goodbye.